Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Watchung Hills and Script and Cue performance. Now, at this time, we ask that you turn off your device and refrain from taking photographs or recording the show. Please turn to the person next to you and thank them for turning off their device so that you might enjoy the performance. Now, sit back, relax, as I take you into the woods. Once upon a time, in a faraway kingdom,
more than anything,
lived a young maiden,
more than life,
a sad young lad,
more than jewels,
and a childless baker.
More than life,
I wish,
with his wife,
more than anything,
more than the moon,
I wish,
the king is giving a festival.
More than life,
I wish to go to the festival.
More than riches,
I wish my cow would give us some milk.
More than anything,
I wish we had a child.
I want a child. I wish to go to the festival.
I wish we might have a child.
I wish.
You wish to go to the festival?
The Pearl Ogre's mother had died.
You sent her on the festival?
Wait, you sent her on the festival?
You wish to go to the festival? The festival? The king's festival?
And her father had taken for his new wife.
The festival!
A woman with two daughters of her own. All three were beautiful of face, but vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother,
I wish,
she was not quite beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish my house were not a mess. I wish my cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were made of gold. I wish a lot of things. Jack, you foolish child, what in heaven's name are you doing with the cow inside the house?
A warm environment might just be what Milky Way needs to produce his milk.
He's a she. How many times must I tell you that only she's can give milk? Oh, God.
Oh, I come in, little girl.
I wish. It's not for me, it's for my granny in the woods. A loaf of bread, please, to bring my poor old hungry granny in the woods. Just a loaf of bread, please.
Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I have emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have picked them out again in 2 hours' time, then you shall go to the ball with
and
us.
And perhaps a sticky pie. Birds in the sky, birds in the eaves, in the leaves, in the fields, in the castles and ponds.
And a few of those plum little birds,
please.
Down from the eaves and the leaves, over fields, out of castles and ponds.
No sweet
late.
And save some of those sweets for Granny.
bring some bread to Granny, who is sick in bed. Never can tell what lies ahead, for all that I know, she's already dead. But into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, to Grandmother's house and home before dark.
Fly, birds, back to the sky, back to the eaves and the leaves and the fields and the...
Hurry up, my hair, Cinderella, are you really right?
Here I found a little tear, Cinderella, can you hide it with a hat?
You look beautiful.
I know.
She means me.
Put it in a twist.
Mother said be good, father said be nice, that was always their advice, so be nice, Cinderella, good, Cinderella, nice, good, good.
Tighter!
What's the good of being good if everyone is blind and you're always left behind? Never mind, Cinderella, kind Cinderella, nice, good, nice, kind, good, nice.
Not that tight.
I'm sorry.
Claude.
Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident. He was eager to have a family of his own, but was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
We have sold our last loaf of bread.
Oh! Oh, it's the witch from next door.
We have no bread.
Of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish.
It's what you wish.
Nothing cooking in there now, Lou.
The witch went on to explain to the couple she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was... greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and little birds, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't quite till I caught it in the audit in my garden one night. Who's robbing me? Who's raping me? Raining through my rutabaga, begging, raining my arugula, I'm tripping up the raspberry, my champion, my favorite. I smell it, I fell on him right there. Could have turned him into stone. Or a dog. Or a chair. Let him have the rampy and I'd lots to spare. In return, however, I said, fair is fair. You let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it square.
Wait, I had a brother?
No, but you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable and that we all might live happily ever after. But I was like to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket. You see, when I had inherited that garden, my mother had warned me that I would be punished if I were ever to lose any of the...
You're getting older, the floor's gone slack, your mother's getting older.
sir, your father's not back, and you can't just sit here dreaming pretty dreams. To wish and wait from day to day will never keep the wolves away. So into the woods, the time is now, we have to live, I don't care how. Into the woods to sell the cow, you must begin the journey. Straight to the woods and don't delay, we have to face the marketplace. Into the woods to journey's end.
Into the woods to sell a friend.
Someday you'll have a real pet, Jack.
A piggy?
Meanwhile, the old enchantress, for purposes of her own, explained how the baker might lift the spell.
You wish to have the curse reversed. I'll need a certain potion first. Go to the wood and bring me back one the cat as white as milk. Two, the cake as red as blood. Three, the hair as yellow as corn. Four, the slipper as pure as gold. Bring me these before the chime of midnight. In 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be.
Thank you.
Go to the wall!
Darling those nails, darling those clothes. Lentils are one thing, but darling with those, you'll make us the fools of the festival and mortify the prince.
Our parish is waiting.
We must be going.
Good night, Father.
Oh. I wish.
Look what I found in Father's hunting jacket.
6 beans.
Yes, I wonder if they're
the witch's beans. So we'll take them with us.
I'm coming.
I know you were fearful of the woods at night.
No, the spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
The spell is on our house. We must
you are
lift
not
the spell
coming,
together.
That is
the spell is on our house.
What am I to return with?
You don't remember. The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
Ask for Cinderella.
I so wish to go to the festival.
The cow is white as milk,
but how am I ever to get to the festival? I know I'll visit Father's grave,
the slipper is pure as gold. I wish. Please, no.
Silver and quiver, little tree. Silver and gold, throw down on me. I'm off to get my wish.
Quiet. Silence everywhere, Milky White. Not to my liking.
Hello, Jack.
How did you know my name?
When first I appear, I seem mysterious. But when explained, I'm nothing serious.
See that again?
On your way to market. You might have been there long ago, taking your time, Jack.
No, sir.
Is that the truth?
Well, you see, I was resting.
How much are you asking for the animal?
No less than £5.
Now, Jack! Why such a sum?
Well, you see, my mother...
Your mother? A boy your age? Why, you'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
Well, I... Come along, Milky White. There are spirits here.
Good day, little girl.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket there?
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league further in the woods. Her house stands under three large oak trees.
Look at that flesh, pink and plump. Hello, little girl. Tender and fresh, not one lump. Hello, little girl. This one's especially lush. Delicious. Hello, little girl, what's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not to delay or be misled.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first, then Miss Plum. What a delectable couple. Utter perfection, one breed or one suck. For one moment, my dear.
Come with me, follow the path and never stray.
To so little girl, any path, so many worth exploring. Just one would be so boring. And look what you're ignoring. Think of those crisp, aging bones. Then something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your meal.
Mother said not to stray. Still, I suppose a small delay. Granny might like a fresh bouquet.
Goodbye, little girl. And hello. Ow!
It was harm to come to that little girl in the... Oh, that red cape.
Forget the little girl and get the cape!
You frightened me. How am I supposed to get it?
You go up to the little thing and you take it!
I can't just take a cape from a little girl. Why don't you get it?
I can't! I would if I could!
Get me what I need! is ridiculous. You'll never get that red cape, nor the golden cow, or the yellow slipper. Or was it a yellow cow and a golden slipper? No. It was definitely a golden slipper. But what was the cow? Brown?
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn.
What are you doing here?
You forgot your scarf.
No. You have no right being alone in the woods, and you have no idea what I've come upon here. It will frighten you for your life. Now go home immediately.
I wish to help.
No, the spell is on my house.
Our
only
house.
I can lift the spell.
We must lift the spell
house.
Together. The spell.
A cow as white as milk.
Hello there, young lad.
Hello,
what might
sir?
You be doing with a cow in the middle of the forest?
I was heading towards market, but I seem to have lost my way.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And what are you planning to do there?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? Yes. Where am I to get 5 pounds?
Oh, she must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you cannot fetch that sum, then what are you to do?
I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I would have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans with... Oh, we mustn't give up our beans. Oh, well, if you feel we must.
What?
Son, beans will bring you food.
Beans? In exchange for my cow?
These are no ordinary beans, son. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him.
What magic? That magic? Magic that defies description.
My mother would.
You'd be lucky to exchange it for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
6.
5. 5. We can't part with all of them. We must have one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say these beans are worth a pound each at the very least.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
No. Yes, well, perhaps. Well, good luck there, young lad.
I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been the perfect friend. I hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, you won't be on a plane.
Take the cow and go home.
I was trying to be helpful.
Magic beans? We have no reason to believe they're magic. Are we going to dispel this curse through deceit?
No one would have given him more for this creature. We did him a favor, at least they'll have some food.
5 beans?
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you'll live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in-betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic. Who knows? Why you do what you do, that's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her, she's crying.
Everything you do is pure in intent. If it's meant, if it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important, really, is the size.
What are you talking about?
Only 3 more tries and we'll have our prize. When the end's in sight, you'll realize. If the end is right, it justifies the
and go home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cape as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, The witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her away within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. And when the old enchantress paid a visit, she called forth.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, what a strange name. Strange, but beautiful and fit for a prince. Tomorrow, with that horrible witch arise, I will stand beneath her tower and ask her to let down her hair to me. Hello, little girl.
Hello.
Have you saved some of those sweets for Granny?
I ate all the sweets and half the loaf of bread.
Oh, my. What a lovely red cape. Oh, I so admire it.
My granny made it for me.
Is that right? Oh, well, I would just love a red cape like that one.
You'd look pretty foolish.
May I take a look?
Oh, I don't like to be without my cape. Please give it back.
But I want it badly.
Give it back, please.
Give it back.
Forget the little girl and get the cape.
What? Okay. I just wanted to make sure that you really love your cape. Yes, now you go run along to your granny's and make sure that no wolf comes your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day. Bye!
You need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak, what's a cloak? It's a joke, it's a stupid little cloak. And a cloak is what you make it, so you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the baker, with newfound determination, went after the red cape. As for the little girl, she was surprised to find the door to her grandmother's cottage standing open.
Oh dear, how uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets. Good day, grandmother. My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what big eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what large hands you have.
The better to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, grandmother. What a terrible big wet mouth you have!
Better to eat you with!
And scarcely had the wolf said this when with a single bound he was devouring the little girl. It was a full day of eating for both. And with his appetite appeased, the wolf settled down for a nice, long nap.
Oh my. What a mighty snore that grandmother has. Where is that little one? Off eating, no doubt. Or eating? What the? Oh, grandmother. What is that little piece of red cloth by the corner of your mouth? It looks to be a part of that. Oh, I know. I'll get this red cape from inside your stomach.
Yes.
Don't you want the skins?
No! No, you can keep the skins, yes.
What kind of a hunter are you?
I'm a baker!
Baker?
Mother said straight ahead, not to delight or be misled. I should have heeded her advice, but he seemed so nice. and he showed me things, many beautiful things that I hadn't thought to explore. They were off my path, so I never had dared. I had been so careful, I never had cared. And he made me feel excited, well, excited and scared. When he said, come in, with that sickening grin, how could I know what was in store? Once his teeth were bared, though I really got scared, well, excited and scared, but he drew me close and he swallowed me down, down a dark, slimy path where lie secrets that I never want to know. And when everything familiar seemed to disappear forever, at the end of the path was Granny once again. So we waited in the dark until someone set us free, and we're brought into the light, and we're back at the start. And I know things now, many valuable things that I hadn't known before. Do not put your faith in a cape and a hood. They will not protect you the way that they should. And take extra care with strangers. Even flowers have their dangers, and though scary is exciting, nice is different than good. Now I know, don't be scared. Granny is right, just be prepared. Isn't it nice to know a lot? And a little bit not. Mr. Baker, you saved our lives. Here.
Are you certain?
Yeah. Maybe Granny will make me a new one with the skins of that wolf.
Thank you. Thank you!
And so the baker, with the second article in hand, feeling braver and more fulfilled than he had ever felt, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack. Oh,
only a dolt would exchange a cow for beans!
Mother, no!
Off to bed without supper for you!
Little did they know, those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Now!
My breath.
Oh, what a beautiful gown you're wearing. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Oh, aren't you the lucky one? Whatever are you doing in the wood at this hour?
We must find her and sue. We don't have much time left.
Indeed, sir.
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see her! Over there!
Well, move!
I've never lied to royalty before. I've never anything to royalty before.
Thank you.
If a prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide.
Well, what brings you here?
Oh, and with a cow. Well, my husband's in the woods somewhere. He's undoing a spell.
Oh, yes.
Oh, but the prince. Oh, the prince, what was he like?
The prince? He's a very nice prince.
And?
It's a very nice ball.
And?
When I entered, they trumpeted.
And? The prince?
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? See, charming. They say that he is charming.
We did nothing but dance.
Yes.
And it made a nice change.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
He has charm for a prince, I guess.
Yes.
I don't need a white rage, and it's all very strange.
Well, are you to return to the festival tomorrow, Eve?
Perhaps.
Perhaps. To be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I would give to be in your shoes.
Would you look over there? An enormous vine blowing us that little cottage.
I mean slippers.
It looks like a giant beanstalk rising into the sky.
As pure as gold.
I must get home.
I need your shoe. Hey!
One midnight gone.
No, not unties itself.
Sometimes the things you most wish for are not to be touched.
The harder to get, the better to have. Agreed? Agreed.
Never wear more than a ball.
I'm pink!
Or open your mouth. The difference between a cow and a bean is a bean can begin an adventure.
The closer to the family, the closer to the wine.
One midnight dog! How will the wolf stop him?
A servant is not just a dog to a prince.
Opportunity is the visitor. You may know what you need, but to get what you want, better see that you keep what you have.
One midnight dog!
The woods
at home before.
There were giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below at the world you left and the things you know, little more than the glance is enough to show you just how small you are. Way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, where the sky is lead and the earth is stone. You're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you never dare, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she draws you close to her giant breast, and you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you meet a friend and all, and you know she's big, but you don't feel small. Some bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared of being all alone. And then that you long for the things you've known in the world you left and alone. You own the fun is done. You steal what you can and run. You scramble down and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The roof, the house, and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky! Good fortune, sir. Look what I have. Here's 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces?
I had more, but my mother made me surrender them. She left me these 5 to do with as I please.
Oh, my.
Where's Milky White?
Oh, Milky White's back at home with my wife.
Well, let's go find them.
Wait. I don't know that I wish to sell.
But you said I might buy her back.
Well, yes, but I don't know that 5 gold pieces
would... Are you saying that you wish more money?
More money would always...
Keep this. I will go fetch more.
Wait, no, that wasn't what I was saying. Wait. 5 gold pieces. Oh, 5 gold pieces. Oh, with this money, I could buy baking supplies for a year. I could buy a new thatched roof and a new chimney.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. But when explained, I'm nothing serious. Could you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces, 10, 20?
Never thought to put a price on it.
Exactly. You've not thought about a great many things, have you, son?
What are you doing? Give that back. That's not yours.
Nor is it Jack's. The money is not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
Oh, come back here, damn. Give me that back. And what are you doing here now?
Oh, I see you have the red cape.
Yes, I have the cape. Only 2 items left to locate.
3.
2. I have the cape and the cow.
You've the cape.
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away. I never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to have entrusted her to you.
Oh, well, she might have just as easily have run from you.
But she didn't.
But she might have.
But she didn't
but
run
she
from
might
me.
Have.
She ran from
cow.
You. She didn't. She couldn't have run from me because she was leaving my cow. We were just going to go do that. I can offer you this.
Don't give me that! I don't want to touch it! Have you no sense? Oh, my Rapunzel, listen to her beautiful music. Oh, lovely.
Oh, she is very gifted.
By tomorrow's midnight, deliver the items or you wish you never thought to have a child! Oh. 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 Oh.
I do not like that woman.
I am sorry I lost the cow.
I shouldn't have yelled. Now please, will you go back to the village? I will make things right, and then we can just go back to our lives. No more hunting about in the woods for strange objects. No more witches, or curses, or dim-witted little boys, or hungry little girls. No, no, no. You go that way, I'll go this way.
I've been looking all night. For her.
Her?
The beautiful girl I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared. Like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here in the woods.
In the woods?
Yes, at the top of a tall tower with no doors or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues due east, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
I stand beneath her tower, and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel? Rapunzel? Mm-hmm. What kind of name is that? You jest. I've never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She's as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
And yet one has.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain this heart she has won from me? Agony! One thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Go with you if there only were doors. Agony, oh, the torture they teach. What's as intriguing
or half as fatiguing as what's out of reach?
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and there to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why not?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad. Oh.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her ah.
Agony, misery, although it's different for each. Always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like knife.
I must have her to
walk. Two princes, each more handsome than the other. Get the hair.
Excuse me, young woman. Hey! Have you encountered a young boy with carrot top hair and a sunny, though occasionally vague, disposition? Answers to the name of Jack.
Oh, not the one partial to a white cow.
Yes, that's the one.
Have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't ever care to again. Children can be very queer with their animals. You be careful with your children.
I have no children.
Well, that's okay, too.
Yes, well, I've not seen your son today.
Oh, well, I hope he didn't go up that beanstalk again. God. Jack! Jack! Oh, quit while you're ahead, I say. Jack! Jack! Hey! Oh!
Where is that cow? Moo! Moo! Moo!
Moo!
Oh,
looking for your cow. Oh,
yes. Where'd you find her? Hello?
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
I want you to old man.
I'm here to see that your wish is granted.
You've caused enough trouble. Stay out of my path.
Oh, God. Stop. Oh, it's hot and cold. How? How is it hot and cold?
Tower. I hope there are no witches to encounter here. Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me.
Is that you, my prince?
Yes.
Oh, excuse me for this.
Not to fear, maiden. One more.
Oh! My goodness, you do take plenty of spills, don't you?
Hello. It's these slippers. They're not suited for these surroundings. Actually, they're not suited for much dancing either.
Oh, I'd say these slippers were as pure as gold.
They're everything you can wish for in beauty.
What I would give for just one.
One isn't likely to do you much good.
Was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
Yes.
And? They have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh? Who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes,
and I'm not in the mood. He must have really taken a liking to me.
I have no experience with princes and castles and gowns.
Nonsense.
Every girl dreams of such things.
I think I saw her go this way.
Oh, I'm sure, sir.
And I must have
of course I'm sure, you idiot. Oh, move!
Stop that!
I needed to have a child. Oh.
And I needed to get out of here! Oh, yeah! Yeah.
Where did she go?
Who?
Don't play that fool, woman!
The maiden, the beautiful maiden in the ball gown. She went in that direction. I was trying to hold her here for you.
I can catch my own damsel, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Where did he go?
Who?
The prince, of course!
Yes!
That direction, but you'll never reach them.
We would have if that mongrel with a cow hadn't molested us.
Cow?
Oh, please, let me just compare this color with that of your own.
He wants to compare her hair to corn!
Please,
Where did he go? I don't know.
I thought you were returning home. I've had no luck.
You've the cow.
Yes, I've the cow. Only two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three. Compare this to your corn.
Where did you find it?
Oh, I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Three.
Oh, and I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
We have an entire day left. Surely we can locate a slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well, I mean, perhaps it will take two of us to get this child.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted than I knew you to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough, it's not true. It takes two of us, you came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It takes two of us, it takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. You swear to change, you can tell if you do. It takes two.
You've changed. You're thriving. There's something about the woods. Not just surviving. You're blossoming in the woods. At home, I fear we'd stay the same forever. And now, out here, you're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
Takes one to begin, but then once you've begun, it takes two of you, it's no fun. But what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us as a pair of us, which accept and share of what's there.
We've changed. We're strangers. I'm meeting you in the woods. Who minds what dangers? I know we'll get past the woods. And once we're past, this won't change is past. Beyond woods, beyond witches and slippers and hoops. Just the two of us beyond the lies. Safe at home with our beautiful prize.
Just a few of us.
It takes trust. It takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we had none. We've got three. We need one. It takes two.
Stop her! Stop that hen! Oh,
Providence, my milky white, and the owners, and my hen.
Look what this hen has just dropped into my hand.
Oh, a golden egg. I've never seen a golden egg.
You see, I promised you more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you, sir.
5 gold pieces?
Now I'm taking my cow.
5 gold pieces?
Wait, I never said I would sell.
But you took the 5 gold pieces.
You took 5 gold pieces?
I did not take, you gave.
Where are the 5 gold pieces?
What, there was this old man.
You said I could have my cow back.
No, I never said you could, I said you might.
You would take money before a child.
No, it's not like that, promise me. Yes, it might be for the roof, but it's not like that, I promise.
Milky White is dead!
2!
Better than far, but it still isn't there.
Maybe better than far, but it still isn't there.
The ball
so near,
so far.
You never left somebody else's child.
Human is gone.
The way you love.
So near.
Your own.
The prince. So far.
The greatest prize can offer my empty the thorniest path.
Two midnights gone, and the exhausted baker and his wife buried the dead Milky White.
You must go to the village in search of another cow.
Oh, and what do you propose I use to purchase this cow?
Here, take this. Tell them it's magic.
No person with a brain larger than this is going to exchange a cow for a bean.
Fine, then steal it.
Oh, steal it. Just 2 days ago, you were accusing me of exercising deceit in securing the cow.
Then don't steal it and resign yourself to a childless life.
I feel it best you go for the cow. As I have met a maiden with the golden slipper these previous eves, and I believe I will succeed in winning one of her shoes.
Fine.
Fine.
No, you know what? That is just
fine,
simply-
That is just fine!
Unfortunately for Rapunzel.
No!
The witch learned of her affections for the prince before he could spirit her away.
Did I clearly say children should listen?
No, please.
What were you not to do? Children must see.
No.
And learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince. Oh, but I am old. I am ugly.
Thank you.
Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor? I will not share you, but I will show you a world you have never seen!
No! No! No!
When is a white cow not a white cow?
I don't know. Leave me alone.
Haven't I left you alone enough?
Your questions make no sense, old man. Go away.
In exchange for a cow.
What a beautiful cape.
Stay away from my cape or I'll slice you into 1,000 bits.
I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made it for me from a wolf that attacked us. And I got to skin the animal. And best of all, she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have. A hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from that hen. Where'd you get that egg?
Stole it from the kingdom of the giants up there. And if you think that's something, you should see the golden harp the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes without your even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I'm not a liar. I'll get that harp. You'll see.
The witch returned to the tower to take the prince by surprise. And when he left, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. Okay. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final night of the festival.
He's a fairy smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, who cares? This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought. What would be his response? And then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although, how can you know who you are till you know what you want, which you don't? So which do you pick? Where you're safe out of sight and yourself, but where everything's wrong? Or where everything's right and you know that you'll never belong? And whichever you pick, do it quick as you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting and dull. Once you're there, though, it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you stall long enough, cause you're still standing stuck in the stuff on the steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes, the vermouth out of the blue, and without any guide, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You'll just leave him a clue, for example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew, on the steps of the palace.
No, please just hear me out!
We have nothing to discuss! You've attacked me once before!
I did not attack you, I attacked your shoe! I need it! Here! Here is a magic bean in exchange for it.
Magic bean?
sense.
Oh, don't do that.
I've already given up one shoe this evening. My feet cannot bear to give up another.
Oh, no, 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 wait, please, please. I need that shoe to have a child.
Well, that doesn't make any sense.
Well, does it make sense that you're running from a prince?
Stop!
Oh, here, here, take my shoes. You'll run faster.
Who was that woman?
I do not know, sir.
Lying will cost you your life.
I swear I've done nothing.
I'm the cow.
I'm the slipper. We've all four.
I shall take this to the prince, and we shall search the kingdom tomorrow for the maiden who shall best fit this shoe.
No, it's mine. I don't care if it costs me my life.
Give her the slipper and...
What was that noise?
Sir! Just a bolt of lightning in a far-off kingdom.
How dare you take off and search without me?
My apologies, sir. I thought
that might... what you thought. I employed a ruse and had the entire stairway smeared with pitch.
And there, when she ran down, remained the maiden's slipper.
Brilliant!
I thought so. It did leave quite a mess when the other guest left.
And sir, I've obtained the other slipper.
Give her the slipper, and all will come to a happy end.
And who are you, old man?
When first I appear, I seem deleterious.
Oh, shut up.
Do as he says. He's clearly a spear of some sort, and we only need one.
Yes.
Oh, there's a dead giant in my backyard! I heard Jack coming down the stalk calling for his axe, and when he reached the bottom, he took it and began hacking down the stalk, and then suddenly, with a crash, the beanstalk fell, and there was no Jack. For all that I know, he's been crushed by the ogre.
The worrying will do you no good.
If he's safe, then he's safe. And if he's dead, well then there's nothing we can do about that now, is there? We must be off. I need my rest before tomorrow's search is to commence.
Well, doesn't anyone care that a giant has fallen from the sky?
He is dead, is he not?
Well, with such a thought, I would suppose.
The third midnight is here. No! You've all the objects?
Yes, slipper.
Cake cow.
That cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Oh, she is. She is.
No.
This cow has been covered in flour!
Well, we had a cow as white as milk. Honestly, we did.
And where is she?
She's dead.
You know, we thought you'd prefer a live cow.
Of course I'd prefer a live cow. So bring me the dead cow and I'll bring her back to life.
Wait, you can do that?
Now!
Oh, okay, yes.
Oh, Jack, there you are! I've been worried sick!
Mother, look! The most beautiful harp!
Oh, Jack! You have stolen too much! You could have been killed coming down that plant!
It's too heavy!
What's happening? Milky White! Now I have two friends. A cow and a harp.
Quiet! Feed the objects to the cow.
What?
You heard me. Feed them to the cow. Fill this.
I'll do it. She'll only milk for me. Squeeze, pal.
Wrong ingredients. Forget about a child.
No. You wait one moment. We followed your instructions. One, that cow was as white as milk, correct?
Yes.
And two, that cape was as red as blood?
Yes.
And three, the slipper.
Yes.
And four, I can
compare this hair with corn.
I pulled that hair from a maiden in a tower.
You what? What were you doing then?
Nothing happened to me, cousin boy.
I touched that hair. Don't you understand? I cannot untouch the ingredients.
No.
I don't know. The corn! The corn!
What?
The silky hair of the corn. Pull from the ear and feed it to the cow. Quickly!
This had better work, old man, before the last stroke of midnight, or your son will be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son?
Please not now.
Yes. Meet your father.
Father? Father, could that be you? But I thought you died in a baking accident.
I didn't want to run away.
Oh, it's working!
I don't understand.
Not now. Into the cup.
All right. We've given you what you wish.
Now, when can we expect a child?
What's wrong?
What's happening?
Where are you going?
Son!
Father!
Oh, he's repaired.
He's dead.
And so the mysterious man died, having helped end the curse on his house. For the baker and his father, there would be no reunion. And the baker and his wife, bewildered,
returned home.
And the witch, cursed with age and ugliness the night the lightning flashed and the beans were stolen, was now restored to her former state of youth and beauty. And Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with the now wealthy Jack. As for the prince, continued his search for the foot to fit the golden slipper. And when he reached Cinderella's house, his stepmother took the slipper into Florinda's room. Which one's Florinda? Who can tell?
Careful, my toe!
Darling, I know, what do we do?
You'll have to go, but when you're his bride, you can sit or ride. You'll never need to walk.
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain and went off to join the prince to become his bride. The prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on the slipper.
Oh my god! I am!
Why won't it fit?
Darling, be still. Cut off a bit of the heel and it will. When you're his wife, you'll have such a life. You'll never need to walk.
No! No! Please!
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain. But as she was helped along by the prince, he noticed a trickle of blood falling from the slipper.
Have you no other daughters?
To which the woman replied,
no!
Only a stunted little kitchen wench which his late wife left behind. But she is much too dirty and she cannot be seen.
I insist.
Really,
and when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, It fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
I've always wanted a son.
Much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, the prince took Cinderella to become his bride.
I've always wanted a son.
Shut up!
As for Rapunzel, she bore twins and lived impoverished in the desert until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a sound so familiar he went towards it. And Rapunzel, upon seeing him, fell into his arms weeping. Two of her tears wetted his eyes and restored his vision.
Oh.
I was just going to come get you just as soon as you learned your lesson.
Who are you?
Surely you remember.
Mother?
This is who I truly am. Come with me and we can be happy as we once were.
She will not go with you.
Let her speak for herself. You are the only family I know. Come with me. You and those beautiful babies. Please.
No.
Then you give me no choice!
As is often the case in these tales, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her power over others. On the night the wedding with the prince was celebrated, Lucinda and Florinda attended, wishing to garner their sister's favor and share in her good fortune. But as they stood by the blessed couple, pigeons swooped down upon them and pecked out their eyes, cursing them with blindness.
Yes.
Thank you for the slipper.
I didn't think I'd wed a prince.
I didn't think I'd ever find you.
I didn't think I could be so happy.
And it came to pass, all that seemed wrong was now right. Kingdoms filled with joy, and those who deserved to certain to live a long and happy life. Ever after. Journey over, all's mended, and it's not just for today, but tomorrow, unextended, ever after.
Ever after!
All the curses have been ended, the reverse is wiped away, all is tenderness and laughter, for forever after.
Happy now and happy as and happy ever after.
There were dangers and confusions, and the path would often swerve. There were conflicts, disillusions, but they never lost their nerve. And they reached the right conclusion, and they got what they deserved.
Not a sigh and not a sorrow, tenderness and laughter. Joy today and bliss tomorrow and forever after.
When you see your wish pursue, it's a dangerous endeavor,
but the only thing to do.
Those fearful, those steep, those darkly dangerous, the path they make goes careful.
Those steep,
you must
obey,
you must obey,
you must obey,
you must obey,
you must obey,
you must obey,
you must
obey, you must
obey,
you must obey,
you must obey,
you can't just wish, but to get your wish, you go into the woods where nothing's clear, where witches, ghosts, and wolves appear. Into the woods and through the fear, you have to take the journey. Into the woods and down the dell, in vain perhaps, but who can tell?
Into the woods to lift the spell.
Into the woods to lose the longing.
Into the woods to have the child.
To wed the prince.
To get the money.
To save the house.
To kill the wolf.
to get, to save, to kill, to keep, to go to the festival, into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods.
To be continued,
and happy ever after.
Now, we will be taking a brief 15-minute intermission, but don't worry. There is much more of this story to tell.